Welcome to CC online lecture. Students, in this session I will talk about sales reports and documents. Now we need to understand that companies have to track the performance of their salespeople on a regular basis. At the same time, even the salesmen need to know how well they have performed their selling job. So they need certain reports and documents in an organized manner which can provide them with all this information. This is what a sales report is. So broadly we can understand reports as the documents in which the information is organized in a systematic manner for a specified purpose. Now, not only they help you to enhance the performance as a salesman, but also helps the salespeople in modifying the selling processes and making them more effective in future. In a way, we can understand, students, that reports and documents, they serve a very important purpose in selling, because through them the salespeople can understand the reasons behind the results and can focus on the areas of concern. The reports also help them to decipher the variation in performance with respect to salesmen when it comes to the business entity. So they company or an enterprise can figure out how one salesman has performed in comparison to the other, what is the difference in the number of the prospects identified, the number of people contacted by them, or the targets achieved by them. Generally, we find that the sales reports are prepared on a periodic basis, and the periodicity of the report, that is the specified period for which you are making the report, it generally depends on the needs of the business entity. So accordingly, you can generate the reports on a daily basis or a weekly basis, and even on a quarterly or annual basis. Now here I have also given you a snapshot of how the weekly sales report is going to look. So the weekly activity report tells the company about the activities being carried out by a salesman during the week. Now, other than helping the salesman and the business entity in getting to know the information at one proper place, what are the other benefits then we can have from preparing a sales report? So the first thing is obviously that it helps the salesman in getting a genuine communication, or the company in having an access to a genuine communication. Like for example, a daily sales report can help the business in learning more about the sales processes which happened during that particular day. Generally, such tools can help not only in making the sales process more effective but also more personal, especially for the customers. Even if you have lot of clients with you, you can keep a file for each one of them, and you can jot down the main points for each of the customers, like the kind of products that they have ordered and the other relevant details pertaining to that particular individual. So through this, what a salesman can achieve, he would get a very focused result and would also be in a position to deliver a better experience to the customer each and every time. Another benefit, students, that we can understand from the preparation of these documents is that the sales report, they help you in saving a lot of time. So the sales people, because they get easy access to information, the time that they save in the process, that can be put wisely in order to generate more income for the company. So to do this, it would really be beneficial if the company asks the salesman to produce a daily report, and the reports would generally contain all the relevant information, and therefore it can be accessed very quickly and very easily. If all the information is centralized at one place and in one location, then obviously it is going to become a lot easier for both the enterprise as well as for the sales people to learn and to have easy access to information through these reports. Another thing which makes them really relevant for an enterprise is that salespeople can improve on their selling techniques or strategies for client acquisition, or what we call as the customer acquisition. So what happens is, through these reports, the salesman can identify the leads and the prospects very easily and also with a lot of accuracy. They can use this information to then focus on their selling processes, their selling techniques, or their communication efforts. This is particularly with respect to the client's acquisition, and therefore you are going to spend considerably less time in contacting or approaching your prospects, or even in terms of expenses of determining whether the client is worth it or worth pursuing or not. You would be reducing your expenses in doing this exercise. So this means that all in all, the salespeople would have higher chances of speaking to the clients who are more receptive. Another advantage that is associated with the report is that you can analyze this kind of data that you get in the reports for the development planning. So what an enterprise can do, they can use this particular data on the reports to their own advantage, and they can analyze this data to generate useful insights. And these useful insights can then be helpful for that particular business to boost up their level of sales or to close the deals more effectively, or enhance the accuracy of your forecast. We have already stated that the sales reports, they document the information. So another big advantage is that you have got all the important information. Now what happens is, whenever there are certain changes in the organizations, these kind of reporting tools would help, because they would serve as a reference material. They contain all that information which you may need as a reference, and therefore you can recall that important information every time you need to connect with a client of the past. Another advantage that we can cite here, students, is that because of the above mentioned benefits, we see that the preparation of the sales report and a regular referencing of these reports allow the salespeople to deliver a very good client experience. So the customers who work with the organization, they expect par excellence experience with the enterprise, which they can compare with the competing firms. So managing the customer relationship in a timely manner is going to really enhance your potential in the market, and you would be able to form relationships in a much easier manner in the long run. So to do this exercise, the reports turn out to be truly helpful. They may seem simple, but they would provide you with a lot of advantages and a lot of information that a company and a salesman can capitalize on. Now, after having read about all these things, let us now talk about what are the broad different types of sales reports. You have to manage so many reports. So it's a, are there specific reports for specific purposes that one needs to prepare? So the answer is yes. There could be different types of reports. I'll start with the important one, which is the call report, which is also known as the progress report. Now, as it is clear from the name itself, the call or the progress reports is going to tell you the details regarding how and how often your sales representatives, they are calling on the accounts which are falling in their assigned territories. The specific data asked for in this kind of a report by the company varies not only by the company, but also varies by the industry, but commonly includes what companies salespeople call on, who they speak to, whether the calls are made with a person in person, through a phone, through a personal meeting, what actually did they talk about, what are the next action steps that they are planning to take, and what are the next scheduled calls. So in a way, it details the entire call at one place and therefore give a snapshot view of everything in one go. Now, call reports, they should be turned in and they should be run on, obviously, preferably on a daily basis, and they should be read very carefully, at least, you know, every other day. Because if you review them after, say, weeks, it would not give you enough time to allow for the verification of information in the report on a timely basis. The second report, students, that we have is the productivity report. So again, this, as is clear from the name, this is going to help the company in getting all the information related to the level of activity which is by and large taking place in the sales department or sales organization, and to also ensure that each salesman is meeting or is exceeding the standards which have been laid down, which have been established for him. The data often includes like the data on the number of outbound calls or the conversations or the voicemails, the meetings which have been held, the sales presentations, and so on and so forth. So the report actually and should compare the actual performance or the actual results with the benchmarks that have been set with you, so that you can see that where is the variation and whether the variation is turning out to be positive or it is turning out to be negative. So obviously, if the productivity or the performance is negative, then there is a scope for making improvements. Again, just like the call reports, the productivity reports also should be turned in, preferably on a daily basis, but then because it becomes a cumbersome exercise, usually they are turned in on a weekly basis. And many managers also make efforts to compare the activities on a regular basis, and also keeps a check to verify whether what is being reported is also correct or not. The third kind of report, students, that now I'm going to talk about is the sales forecast. Now, this again we can understand is something very important for an organization. The sales forecast has got multiple purposes, including not only helping to estimate the revenue, but also in determining what kind of opportunities lay ahead and what kind of activities require the attention, so that you can pave way for the sales in future. This would also relate to the post-sale product or service delivery activities. Now, the accuracy of the sales forecast strongly affects the entire organization and is therefore the one of the most important reports that can be generated. This document generally contains the names the prospects, the sales opportunity, the size of the order, the indications of where the sales opportunities are in the entire sales cycle, what your customers are buying. So the sales representatives best estimate which sales is going to close during a period of, say, next month or 2 months, and in most company is due at the beginning of the each month with, say, some sort of a revisions, really serve a very important purpose in planning the activities ahead. So each salesman should understand what kind of a criteria a potential account must meet before they are allowed to put in on the forecast. Otherwise, the data will actually become meaningless. And once an account has been placed on the sales forecast, it should not be removed by the salesman without having a proper discussion with the manager. Another report which is, you can say, not only important, but it is prepared and gives useful insight to the manager, is the expense report. Now, salespeople, they usually get all the expenses reimbursed, that the expenses that they are, that they incur in the whole process of performing their job. So they submit, let's say, on a weekly basis or on a monthly basis, the nature of the expenditure and the amount of the expenditure that is being incurred by them. And such kind of reports help the business or the enterprise in controlling the nature and the amount of the sale expense. So obviously, this has a lot of implications. The last report that I'm going to talk about, students, here is the lost sale, or also the complaints which are being added therein. So at times we find that the prospects leave the organization and they don't want to transact with your organization or deal with your enterprise in future. So this kind of report is going to have the details of the orders which you had lost during a given period, so that you can assess the reasons, you can go through the comments of the salespeople, you can go through the comments of the customers. If the order got lost because of some complaint that was being filed, that could also be mentioned over there. What is the purpose? So that you can prevent future loss of sales and you can improve on your customer experience, and you can train salespeople as to how they can handle the complaints and how they can make some sort of a redressal mechanism so that they don't lose the orders in future. So obviously this kind of report is going to have important implications and is going to give you important insights to safeguard your orders in future. Now, after students having discussed everything about why we prepare sales reports, why they are important, and what kind of sales reports are prepared in an organization, in the next stage, we need to learn what makes the sales report effective in nature. Right? So too lengthy or too precise reports, they're not going to serve any purpose. So generally, we go by 4C rule. So what are those 4Cs? Your reports have to be clear, they should be concise, they should be correct, and they should be in all way they should be consistent in terms of providing you the information which is required on a daily basis or on a weekly basis. Along with this, there could be certain things or certain tips that one can take into consideration while they are preparing the sales report, so as to enhance the quality of the report and the quality of information that you are embedding in it. So no matter what kind of report you are making, what is the nature of the report, you should always know that there is someone who is going to read it. So the first consideration is that you have to know your customer. You have to know your audience for whom you are preparing the report. So if you know your audience, it will be a lot easier for you to create a report which would be useful for them. So suppose you are writing a daily report and you know that your supervisor or your manager is going to read it, and therefore the report has to be very clear, it is to be very professional. The report must show the needs of the specific audience, what that specific audience would like to read, and whether I as a salesman has embedded that information and has made my report overall useful and efficient or not. So it is very important for whom are you preparing the report, so know your audience. The second important thing that one needs to take into account is that the information should be chosen very carefully. Now, what do we mean by this? When you have identified your audience, think about the kind of information that you would like to share and the information that you would not like to share. So obviously, you don't want to share too many details, but at the same time, you have to actually provide some basic information. In some cases, some of the aspects of the reports need that kind of a detailing also. So you need to include certain details also so that your audience would understand the things in a better manner. Usually, most of the reports they are handed over to the top level management, and therefore they need to be detailed. But the information, such kind of a detailed information may not be required for each and every report that you write. So this is where you need to know whether the person to whom you are submitting the report would be interested in a specific information or he would be interested in a detailed information. Then obviously, students, another thing to keep in mind is that you have to set a time period. Depending on the type of the report that you are making, you need to also set a period to complete it. If it is a daily report, then you should have a deadline for its submission. But when you are deciding, say, for your employees, that what should be the time period, you can be the one who can communicate whether they need to submit a daily report or a monthly report and so on and so forth, because that is going to help them in determining where to focus, what are the areas that they really want to highlight, and how soon they are required to submit their documents. Then you have also at times are required to use the right visual. Sometimes just using the text in the report becomes too much monotonous. So it can really make a lot of difference if you incorporate right kind of visuals along with the information in your document. You also have to keep in mind that not only you are including the content, but the presentation of the content also has to be taken into consideration. So if it is not only what you incorporate, but also how you incorporate that information, which is going to add to the effectiveness and the quality of the report. Another aspect that one needs to take into account is that you have to collect the data for writing the report. So as a salesman, you should know what all information I would like to put in. You cannot create any kind of report without collecting all the data that you need for that particular report preparation. So the salesman or the supervisor, he has to ensure that the information is correct, the information is being procured from the reliable sources, the data is coming from the genuine source, and you also have to learn to collect that particular data in an efficient manner so that you can come up with a compelling and an accurate report. Now students, this was all about sales report. Let us come to the next important document in selling, which is the sales manual. Now, what is a manual? This is a kind of a guidebook. Now, a company depends on the sales team. Now, the performance and the capabilities of the sales team have to be, really very clear. And in order to inform the sales team as to what is expected of them, what are the essential, duties, what is relevant for them and what is not relevant for them, you need to have a framework in place. You need to have a document in place. So sales manual then can be understood as a resource which provides such kind of answers to the salespeople and provide them all the relevant information which they probably need to do their job well, right? So how can we define it? As a document which is prepared in order to guide the salespeople in their selling efforts. What all your sales manual is going to include? It would naturally include what are the features of your product, what are the benefits of the product, how you can sell this particular product, what is the competition, some information about the competition. Now, because we understand that the sales manual is going to inform the salespeople about their relevance to the organization, this instills a kind of confidence in them and guides them about various processes and protocols that they have to follow. So what is going to be helpful for them? If you really give them a proper understanding of all these aspects in the sales manual, so an understanding as to how they fit in, an understanding in terms of outlining their role, understanding of the sales functions. So as you see students, what then we are talking about in a sales manual, we are talking about a fine blend of the processes, the policies of the organization, the practices, the how the function is to be performed, the role that each and every salesman is supposed to do, and so on and so forth. We also have to understand, students, that a strong and an effective sales manual is dynamic in nature. It obviously is going to change as you encounter changes in the market conditions or the changes in the product, in the service. So you want your sales professionals to learn those informations and learn those new things, and therefore you just cannot make one sales manual and freeze it for next 20 years. You have to incorporate the changes as and when there would be changes in the the working of the organization or in the market conditions. So all the sales members, your entire team can contribute to this particular manual, and in fact they should be encouraged to make their contribution and keep on updating the sales manual, highlighting the new procedures that they have come up with or the new competitors on a regular basis. So in fact, you know, it would really be helpful if an organization has got a formal process or probably a kind of a schedule for updating and revising the manual after due intervals of time, so that you keep on updating it on a regular basis. Now, if one needs to understand the importance of sales manual arising from this kind of a discussion that we have just had, we can understand that the sales manual basically helps the sales people in knowing what is happening. So everybody is practically on the same page. They also help the sales team in aligning themselves properly with the rest of the enterprise, its policies, its protocols, and its processes. No doubt, it educates the sales representatives in making their marketing goals and initiatives, and motivates them, energizes them, so to say, with the tools which they need actually to perform their selling function well, or in order to perform their sales job in a well-structured manner. Now, what then should go into the sales manual? You can provide the details of what you sell, you can explain to whom you sell all these things, you can outline the entire selling process in detail, that is how to sell. You can also describe where you can sell, that is the place of the business. You can also communicate why you are selling it. So you are not just selling your products, but you are also marketing, or you are also selling your company. So you can also incorporate the company's history in your sales manual, and you know, you can also incorporate the company's mission statement and the value statement in the manual. And then at the end, you would also have to incorporate the information especially for your sales team on human resource procedures. So you have to manage who sells, including the sales specific policies on probably the hours or the expenditure or the travel and so on and so forth. Again, just like the sales report, your manual should be very effective. It should be simple. It should be confidential. Your employees know that yes, there is a sales manual, but they usually keep it confidential, and it moves within the organization only. Now, students, along with this, we also find some other useful documents in selling. Like you can have an order book where you mention all the orders, you know, the orders which have been placed by the buyer in a phased manner. So you actually maintain proper books. So the sales order not only contain the details of the sales, but also probably the vendor name, the seller name, the order number, the voucher number, so that you have got all the details of that particular order at one place. Similarly, in some of the enterprises, we also find that the salespeople, they maintain a to diary. Generally, because they carry out lot many tours, they actually go on lot many sales tours. So what kind of sales tours were made by the sales people during a specific period of time? So weekly tours or monthly tours, and then they report to the management about their efforts on that particular tour. So to diary will also specify like the place where that particular salesperson visited, what was the mode of the transport, whom did you meet, what was the result achieved in terms of sales order, and so on and so forth. And last, a small document, but then again very important one, that is the cash memo. Now, when you are selling the goods in cash, the seller prepares a cash memo. When you are selling on credit, you prepare an invoice, but the contents of both are more or less the same. So a cash memo is going to list out what? It is going to provide you the details of the suppliers, the name and the address of the supplier and the purchaser, then the serial number, the date of the cash memo, the customer, the quantity of the goods, the rate of the goods, the discount if you have like provided any tax number. No, so all this information is put in the cash memo, and then it is being duly signed by the authorized person, so that you know how much cash flow is coming to the enterprise. So students, these were the important documents which are generally used in the personal selling function. So I'm sure at the end of the session, you would have gained an understanding of the sales reports, manuals, and the other documents which are used by the salespeople in carrying out their selling function. Thank you so much, students, for your patient listening. Thank you so much. Take very good care of yourself. Stay at home. Stay safe.